Hello, everyone, and welcome to my get-together. I'm Aleka, and today we are going to be talking all about chafing dishes. With the holidays coming up quickly, I'm sure you're planning on throwing a party with a lot of food and a lot of people. So the best way to serve a lot of food throughout the party is to use chafing dishes. They are simply large food warmers that you can place anywhere in your house and is really great for self-service or buffet style serving. In this tutorial, we're going to discuss all the parts that make up a chafing dish, and I'm also going to offer my best tips for you to make sure that you're using it properly and your guests have an enjoyable experience when serving themselves. Before I start, know that there's many different types of chafing dishes out there. If you check out the link below, I have a whole blog post on my top chafing dishes from fancy to inexpensive and everything between. So pick one that suits your needs and understand that a chafing dish is an awesome investment if you host family and friends over your house multiple times a year. These will last you a lifetime if you treat them properly. In order to set up your chafing dish, you're going to need everything that encompasses the chafing dish, plus a serving utensil or tongs, a plate, and I'm going to talk about this in a second, a water pitcher, and a stick lighter. Let's get chafing. So the parts of a chafing dish are very simple. We have our lid. Next is our food pan. What do you think goes in here? Our food. And then the big guy below is our water pan. This is where our water is going to go to keep our food warm. Next, what holds your chafing dish up is the rack. This rack is newer. I just got it off of Amazon a little bit ago and I will link to it below. It's awesome because it folds up. Let me show you guys. First, we're gonna take off this, okay? And all you do is just, how amazing. The old school chafing dishes never did this, so this is pretty cool. Now, let's talk about what this is. This is your fuel holder. It holds your fuel cans. These come with your chafing dishes, and they should, and they're meant to hold your sterno lights. They're great because they have a lid and you can slide them closed to extinguish the fire. You can leave them half open to give not as much heat to your food, or you can leave them wide open if you're just starting heating up your food. What goes in these guys? Sterno lights. So my first tip is make sure that you're purchasing the right sterno lights. These fuel cans come in a variety of sizes and heating time, I should say. You can purchase a 2-hour, 4-hour, or even a 6-hour sterno can. I always look for the 6-hour ones because it's better for your fuel to go longer than to extinguish or go out too soon. We're gonna take our sterno cans and pop them into our fuel holder and lock the lid on and place that down onto our rack first, okay? Same thing with the other one. And before you do that, you wanna take off the sterno lid. Just pop it open like a paint can. Once your sterno lights are in, then we're going to put our water pan back on top. Now, my next tip for you is to use a water pitcher that is heat safe, and you're going to fill this up with hot water. Now, the reason why we want to use hot water in our chafing dish is so that our food doesn't take as long to stay warm, right? If we add cold water, then the food, when you add it, it's going to drop in temperature before it comes back up again. So adding hot water is the best way to set up your chafing dishes, especially if you want to serve food to your guests within the next 30 minutes, okay? If you're planning on serving food a couple hours later, like my mother always does, she'll set it up really early in the party. She'll just light it, add the food cold out of the refrigerator, and that's fine to do, but just know it's going to take a lot longer to bring the temperature. And you have to be careful with food when it sits out because you don't want it to drop below that unsafe temperature. So that brings me to my next tip. Have a food thermometer nearby. I love this guy. I got him off of Amazon as well. All you do is insert it into the food it takes literally 3 seconds, and it'll tell you digitally what temperature your food is at, we want to keep it above 140 degrees Fahrenheit. So you should be checking that throughout the party. My recommendation for you is to add preheated food or hot food to your chafing dish so that you don't have to worry about unsafe food temperatures and bacteria growing. And remember, chafing dishes are to keep food warm, not to cook food. So don't ever add uncooked or raw food to your chafing dish expecting it to cook. It ain't gonna happen. Now you're probably wondering how much water to add to your food pan. The standard rule is 1.5 to 2, and I've even seen 3-inch recommendations out there. But this all depends how deep your water pan is and how deep your food pan is. So what we wanna do is make sure that we're adding enough water so that it doesn't evaporate quickly, but not too much to where it touches your food pan, okay? So the best way to test that out is to insert your food pan after the water is already in, plop it down, and then pick it up and see if it's wet. If it's wet, that means it's too high, and wet's not what we want, okay? We just want the steam to warm the food. We don't want the water to warm the food because it will burn. Once our water levels are set, you can leave the food pan off for about 10 minutes so that it can heat up quickly. And then after 10 minutes or so, you can add the food pan with the hot food in, ready to go. Once your water is in your food pan and it's at the right level, you're going to take your stick lighter and you're going to light the fuel cans underneath. And I'm going to take this off so you can see. Now you want to do this underneath. You don't want to take it off because it's hot water that you're moving and it's dangerous and not the best decision. Open your sterno holders, okay? And these lids will be off, obviously. And all you're gonna do is light it. You're gonna light it underneath, boom, and boom. My next tip for you is be careful when lighting your sterno cans because sterno light, the fuel tends to give off an invisible flame. And a lot of the times it will be lit, but you won't be able to tell it's lit. So make sure that you're waiting a minute, you're feeling to see if there's any heat coming off of that can. 9 times out of 10, it is lit and you won't think it is. Now, initially we wanna leave these open so that we get as much heat to our water and food as possible. After about a half hour, an hour, 2 hours, or as the party goes on, you may want to close your holders a little bit so that we're not overheating the food and which will cause it to dry out, which is what we don't wanna do. And then when you're finished with your party, you wanna close both of them and that will extinguish the fire. Now keep in mind, this guy is an 8-quart food pan. This is like for big parties, weddings, huge events, right? Or if you wanna serve something like bigger items like burgers or chicken nuggets, something that is a little bit bigger and will require a lot of space. If you're serving something like a pasta or a veggie, these 4-quart food pans are something you should definitely invest in as well. Sometimes they come with the chafing dish kit, sometimes they don't, but keep an eye out for them, and if they don't, order them separately, and you can add 2 4-quart pans to your 8-quart chafing dish so that you can serve 2 separate side dishes easily. Once our water is in, our sterno lights are lit, you're going to add your food pan. Once your food is in, you can add the lid until you're ready for your guests to serve themselves. You can do this for a couple hours. Just make sure that when your guests are ready to serve themselves, you remove the lid because this is what we don't want to happen. Our guest comes with their plate and they're like, oh, this, I'm so hungry and I want to serve myself, but I don't know where to put this and I need a spoon and where do I put this? How many of you have been in that position? I know I have, okay? Especially if there's a whole line of chafing dishes, there's nowhere to put the lid. So a good hostess will already have this already open for the guests. And the newer chafing dishes, which is why I love this one, has a lid rack or rest on the side. Watch. Boom, look how awesome. It just sits by itself. Another tip, make sure the lid racks are facing away from the guests or against the wall before you set it up. You don't want to have to rotate it during the party. The next thing you want to make sure you do when your guests are serving themselves is have a plate nearby. What do you guys think this is for? To put your spoon or tongs on. Because the next worst thing for a guest is to serve themselves and then not know where to put. You don't want to hand it directly to somebody. You don't want to put it down on the counter. It's going to make a mess on the counter. So have a plate right next to your chafing dish, meaning make sure there's enough room on the table for that as well. My next tip is make sure you're using the right utensils for the right food. For chicken nuggets, french fries, these good old tongs will do the trick perfectly. For something that requires a little bit of a sauce with the pasta, say, a regular large spoon will be perfect. If you're serving something that you don't want super liquidy and a pool of it on your guest plate, use a slotted spoon. My next tip for you is to make sure you're checking your water levels in your water pan every 60 to 90 minutes, I would say. What we don't want is all of our water to evaporate, because then our chafing dish will burn. Okay, so keep an eye on your water level. All you need to do is peek at it and see if there's still some left. It's nice after every hour or two to put about half an inch of water in. Have this nearby, add hot water in, not cold water. We don't want to bring the temperature down, and just have it handy. My next tip is to make sure that you invest in a food thermometer. This guy is going to make sure that your food does not fall below the unsafe temperature of 140 degrees Fahrenheit. If it does, bacteria will grow, and that's not what we want for our guests. Okay, so have this by. This is what I got off of Amazon. You're gonna stick it in the food, and within a couple seconds, it will digitally tell you what the temperature of the food is. So this is awesome to have. When your guests are done serving themselves, you can place the lid back on to keep the food nice and warm, and they'll know they can help themselves if they want seconds or thirds. My last tip for you is to make sure that you buy multiple Sterno cans. If you're having a long party, or if it's Thanksgiving and you have people coming over throughout the day, you wanna make sure that your fuel does not run out. So purchase multiple 6-hour cans. That's my recommendation. It's also important to know that chafing dishes are not the best thing to keep food crunchy. Things like crispy nuggets and french fries or crispy bread will only get soggy inside the chafing dish after a while, because the moisture will make it soggy. So if you want to keep something crispier in, I would suggest adding tin foil with holes to let the steam escape so it doesn't get so soggy as quickly. You can also leave the food half on so that the moisture doesn't get trapped under the lid. And that's all I have for you regarding chafing tips and usage. Make sure you guys check out the link below where I talk about all of the top chafing dishes that I recommend, from fancy to inexpensive and everything in between. And subscribe and like the video below to get more entertaining tips and tricks from me to you. Happy hosting, everybody.